earning $35,000 a month as a photography business owner. Does that sound interesting to you? That's life for Korbin Korzan, owner of Mile High Productions, a photography and videography company that has featured big name clients like HGTV's House Hunters. On this episode, we're gonna feature Korbin, who started Mile High Productions with his wife back in 2015 out of their passion for photography and flying drones. Now, just a year later, he was able to quit his day job to pursue this passion. With an average sales of $35,000 a month and huge profit margins, he was able to expand his team further and hire his first two photographers.
So what was your revenue the first year?
You can get fully going in this for $2,000 or under.
What's the secret to that growth?
We'll also hear about his startup costs, pricing, marketing, client expectation, reputation, branding, and much more. So stay tuned for this amazing episode.
Tell us about your profit margins and what that looks like for your industry. Let's take a look at some of your tricks.
All you're gonna do is just walk right through the door, just like if you were touring the house and you were coming in.
And this is the prime shot for the living area.
So like this video, subscribe to our channel, and let's go meet Korbin and his wife. All right, you guys, we're here with Korbin and his wife, Whitney. And we're gonna hear their story. So you guys, in a quick answer, tell us a little bit about yourself and how you ended up starting a photography company.
Yeah, absolutely. So my name's Korbin. I'm born and raised Washington State. And long story short, I've just always been into photo and video ever since middle and high school, taking any video photo class I could.
Okay.
Got a drone back in 2014, and I was working at Wells Fargo at the time, and I was just flying for fun and doing some small gigs on the side. And a real estate agent approached me at the bank and was like, "Hey, I have a listing coming up. You know, we come out, take a couple photos of my listing. I'll give you a few hundred bucks." And I went, "What would you say? Give me a few hundred bucks to come fly my drone for
that
you?"
Sounds a lot.
Yeah, and so it's like a light bulb just went off in my head, right? And I was like, "Oh, there's a huge market for this. We could take advantage of this."
I started photography right out of high school. I was doing like mini sessions, you know, stuff just to build a portfolio. And then my high school English teacher had actually got engaged, and he was like, "Have you ever shot a wedding?" And I said, "No." And he goes, "Well, do you want to?" And I said, "Yes, absolutely I do." So I shot his wedding the summer I graduated.
Let's talk about your initial budget. What did it take for you to get started? And assuming someone else is looking to get in the industry and has zero, what would they need to expect?
Yeah, so I can tell you right off the bat that you can get fully going in this photo, video, and drone for $2,000 or under.
Okay.
And so what that consists of, what our starting gear bag looked like, was a Canon Rebel T5. It's about $200. A Tokina 11 to 16 millimeter lens on there. It's about $300. DJI Osmo, that we actually did the video tours with, believe it or not. And a DJI Phantom 3. And all of those together, you know, you're looking in a tripod that you need for the photos. You're looking 2,000 or under. We had a laptop that we were able to edit on, so that helped us. We didn't have to buy a laptop. If you got to get a laptop too, you know, you could probably get something around $1,000 that would be decent.
You guys, everyone loves hearing numbers, dollar figures. So what was your revenue the first year? Where is it now? And what's the secret to that growth?
So when we first started, like I said, I was still working at the bank. I would say our first year, we got a few hundred dollars a month.
That's it.
And it took, this doesn't happen overnight. You need to really be consistent with reaching out to everyone and just letting them know who you are, what you're doing, and how you can help them.
Mm-hmm.
Today, 5 years later, we make on average $35,000 per month in sales.
How many clients is that?
Consistently that we work with would be about 400 agents for real estate specifically, which is a huge part of our revenue. This year, especially because COVID has shut down weddings, a lot of them. So generally, weddings are about 30% of our revenue before this year, but it's been cut down a lot. And yeah, I'd say about 60% real estate, 30% weddings, 10% commercial marketing.
Okay. What about the most profitable type of project and least profitable type of project? Can you touch on that a little bit?
It kind of balances itself out because we could shoot, you know, a full day wedding, mm-hmm. and it would be around $4,000. And then we could shoot a full day of real estate and it would be around $4,000. And I mean, we have bigger packages and smaller packages. Like obviously our photo video is more than our just photo or just video or our like vacant land package.
Okay.
It just depends on what you can get into a day, what you have booked and like, you know, the travel time, obviously. I mean, there was one day that we were out for like 12 hours shooting. We only did 3 because it was like back and forth. It was like Gold Bar, Washington, Bellingham, Seattle, yeah. and then back to Monroe.
We're trying to get better at, we're strategic about where our photographers that we hired lived because we knew we're very busy in those areas, but it's a stretch for us to get out yep. there. So okay. we hired one up north, hired one down in Seattle South. We're centrally located. It's perfect. So yep. if we have days like that where we have one in Bellingham mm-hmm. and one in Tacoma,
yep.
we'll send, you know, one person
so well.
Down mm-hmm. south, we'll send one person up north, and then we can get anything that's kind of centrally located around us.
Let's take a look at some of your tricks as far as how you do the work with the cameras, with the equipment. We've got over, 5,000 square feet here,
yes.
so I'm sure there's a lot that you could show, which would be awesome. So stay tuned. We'll check it out.
Okay, so angles are everything. So if you look over here, if I was to shoot the living room from here, lamp, couch, it's kind of a blocked off shot. But if you come over here, you just kind of look at it as you go, you know where your camera's gonna shoot, and then the staging opens up and you can see all the way through the room to the beautiful fireplace. And this is the prime shot for the living area.
Do you guys have a monthly marketing budget? And then what's been the most successful approach in terms of getting new business and getting more clients?
So we actually do not technically have a set marketing budget every month. Up until just a couple of months ago, we did not do any paid advertising. It was all through networking. It was all through social media. It was all through, you know, sending emails ourselves. So that didn't cost us any money. Just a couple of months ago, we were approached by a magazine in Seattle and asked if we would like to be featured in their newest issue. And
that's
we
awesome.
Said, absolutely. And then we did end up paying to upgrade to the front inner cover.
Okay.
So that is now a monthly expense that we have, but it's definitely worth it. But yeah, up until now, while we grew our business, we did not pay for advertising.
And it was all the key words that I'm hearing is networking.
Networking, yes.
Following up.
Yes,
doing
you
that
have to network. Absolutely, yes. Networking, connections. Just like Korbin said, you know, nurturing those relationships and the business will come to you.
Tell us about your profit margins and what that looks like for your industry.
Yeah, so for us, we're very fortunate to have huge profit margins. When we are out shooting, our margin can be above 70% on
wow.
our shoots. And that's
just because you're doing the work.
Because we're doing all the work. And this of course, is after all our gear's been paid for, because we've spent a substantial amount in gear, but it's paid for itself 100 times already over now. Most photographers try to aim for around 30 to 40%.
Okay.
Yeah. After the gear is done and paid for. If you have huge investments in gear and stuff, those numbers are going to be substantially lower.
Right. And as you scale, where do you want to be? What's your sweet spot?
When we're out there doing the work, we want to stay around that 70% or above.
You've got two more photographers
too.
We do. So now,
yeah. Yes. So that's our biggest expense right now is our team members, obviously, because they're out there doing a lot of work and need to get paid. So when we have team members out shooting, the margin will drop from 70 to something more around 30%.
Okay. Walk us through the process of how you go about showing up, yep. setting up, what's important, what to look for, how long it takes, really all those things I think would be really, really interesting for our audience to see.
So you want to be connecting with the agent that you're talking to and asking them, getting some details about the house, the square footage, how many bedrooms and bathrooms there are, if there's any specific shots they're trying to highlight. So before you even get to the house, you have a really good idea of exactly what you're going to be filming.
Mm-hmm.
And it helps you budget time as well.
Yeah, absolutely. So most shoots on average that are around 2 to 4,000 square feet, that's our average home,
is gonna take us because we tag team it and do it together. I do the video and the drone, Whitney does the photos. We're in and out in 1 to 2 hours tops.
Wow, that's pretty quick and lean, I'd say.
So we can hit 6 or 7 homes in a day, just depending where they're located at. If they're all in one general area, easy to do.
All right, we'd love to see you in action. Give us a couple tricks as you're actually performing it. Yeah. And then walk us through it.
Absolutely.
Talk us through it.
So the first step when you're shooting the video is you want to start where you're going to start editing your video. So for here, that's going to be right through the front door. And so the very first thing is I would just start right at the front door. And all you're getting is you're going to get a clip coming. You want to, oops.
There you go. Okay. That happens when you do it.
All right. So you're going to start right at the door here. You want to get a little bit of the door frame in so you can see the door that you're coming in. And then basically all you're going to do is just walk right through the door, just like if you were touring the house and you were coming in. And then what you're going to do next, you're going to go through the entire house and try to shoot it in the way that you're going to edit it, because it's going to make your editing flow way faster.
This concludes part one. I hope you guys really enjoyed it. Some of the things that stood out to me is the simplicity of growing your business, and that is picking up your phone, making that phone call, nurturing those relationships, and making it happen. So thanks again for watching. Like this video, subscribe to our channel, and this is part one. Make sure you check out part two. Link is in the description below or right here. Thanks again, you guys.